Hey guys, welcome to DevOps School. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn about Docker. It helps us to create, deploy, and run applications by using containers. After going through this tutorial, I promise you that the concept and understanding of the Docker will be absolutely clear to you. But before that, let me ask you a few things. Are you dreaming of a career with higher pay and more responsibilities? Or are you ready to take your skills to the next level this year? Then start investing in DevOps School certification level courses, which will help you to emerge skills for a wide range of entry-level roles and as well as higher potential future positions. But with thousands of courses online and in classroom worldwide, finding the right one for your career goals can be difficult. You can consider our courses like Agile Developer, Agile QA, DevOps Certified Professionals, Site Reliability Engineering, DevSecOps, and Masters in DevOps Engineering, where you will have access to well-structured, easy-to-follow course content that has been developed and will be delivered by industry professionals. You can join on our training programs globally through online platforms, and if you are looking for classroom workshops, then we have regular sessions available in Bangalore, Hyderabad, Chennai, Delhi NCR, Mumbai, and in Pune. Simply compare our many courses, find the one that suits your style and schedule best, and start today.
So guys, first question is, what is Docker Compose? Right? What is Docker Compose? So if you want to really understand what is a Docker Compose, you have to understand the problem with the Docker. Problem with the Docker: too much users. Okay, so let's say if your entire stack has been moved to Docker, then what are the things you will do? Let's say this is the app server. Okay, think about it. The problem: this is a web server, and this is the app server, and this is the database server. Now this is the SOA architecture, only a web, app, and database. But actually, if you go into the microservices and all concept, you'll have a lots of services. In the SOA, we have only web, app, and database. Now, web server will have one image, so you will build it, right? You will build it. Now, app server also you'll build it. So one command for this. So let's complete the flow first. So web server, you build it, and then you run it. Okay, run it. Now running with us, so many options again. Now options, some of the options which we have already learned, which is like port mapping, volumes, network, which we have not, but network also, and environment variable, you know, anything, a lot of options you have for the run. After the running, your requirement is over, so you have to stop and then again start. Something modification, some server, again you can do that also. And remove actually. Stop and remove. Okay, this is the one. Now in order to run all this thing, let's say one command, two command with multiple parameter, three command, four command, five command, six command, seven command, eight command, nine command, 10, 11, 12. All together you have a 12 commands. In order to run your one state, let's say assume you are a developer. So more than a coding, you will run the commands: build, run, stop, remove, build, run, stop, remove, with a lot of parameters. This is for the state. As a developer, you want to validate your state. Now if you have a modification in one, only this one, you want to do changes here, then again you will do this one. So like that, overall, to test one small changes, probably you end up running 20 commands for just to validate one small change. Again, I'm repeating, to validate one small changes of your application. This is your whole application, which includes web server, app server, database server. Okay, how many commands you are running? 20 commands. So guys, don't you think you get a frustration? What do you think? Do you get a frustration? 20 commands every 5 minutes you have to run it, and you cannot write a shell scripting also, because container ID get changed, image ID get changed, many things get changed. So you cannot automate this one also. Don't you think you get a frustration? What do you think? What do you think?
Yes.
Yeah. So if you feel that, yes, you will get a frustration, then solution is Docker Compose. So Docker Compose is a tool, is a tool to automate work flow with Docker. When I say workflow, to automate workflow with the Docker, build image, run image, start image, stop image, replace image, start image, stop image, all these things. For what? Services. So to automate workflowing with Docker. Used by developer, image developer. Okay. Now image developer is equal to developer also. Anyone can become a developer now with this in Docker. Okay. So guys, this is the how it is. This is the Docker Compose. Now Docker Compose is a utility which we will install it. I'll do that in demo time. Will reads one file. Okay. Which file? docker-compose.yaml. Yeah, it's a YAML file. Okay. So Docker Compose is a tool. Will read one file, which is docker-compose.yaml, and contains Docker Compose contains what? Contains services. Yes, I said services. Match this. Web service, app service, database service, this service, that service, services. And each services will have options. So let me write it. Service one, service two, service three. It may be having hundreds of services also. And each services will have an option. Which option? Some of the popular option which I am telling you, build, image, build, image, volume, network, port. These are the, you have used it already. Okay. All these things, environment, and many more options. So these options will have some arguments. For example, think about it. It's not very difficult to understand. Build will have what arguments? Any idea? Build will have what arguments?
Build will have the part of the file and the...
No. Build, remember Docker build you did there.
File name of the image.
Docker file, right?
Yeah.
Docker file. Correct?
Yes.
Docker file. Image will have what argument? Image will have image name. Right? Correct? Volumes will have a volume name. So these are the arguments. Okay. Wall name. So these are the arguments, network name, port mapping, environment variable. So it's like this, very simple. So here, this is in discussion, if I match web services, app services, database services. Now guys, think about it, very simple. What is Docker Compose? Docker Compose is a tool to automate workflow with Docker. What workflow? Whatever you do, build, run, start, stop, remove, all these things, links. Here, Docker Compose tool, which reads the file of YAML. YAML has services, multiple services, 1, 2, 3, each services we have, these are the options. And finally, instead of running 20 commands, you run one command and everything is done. What command you should do when everything is done? The command is Docker Compose up. So there is up. Up means build, image, everything will be done in one command. Not too many commands for the too many services. Okay. So here if you have in YAML file, you have a 5-10 services, everything will be done in one go. So Docker Compose up, done. You want to make it all the services down, down. You want to see that up again. You want to start all services in one go, start. You want to stop all the services, stop. You want to remove some services, all the services, remove. You want to again see the logs. You want to see the all these things. So it's a simple thing. Did you understand that now? Guys, did you understand that? Hello? Hello? Guys, I'm out. Yeah. So now, if you have understand things conceptually, then I would like to show you a demo. Can I show you the demo now?
Yeah, one question like that. You know, every time we need to either stop everything or like that. Because if you look at this architecture also, right, always there won't be any change in all
the
data.
True. So here when I say stop, it will stop all the services. But if let's say if you want to only stop one services or only want to remove one service, you just type service name also like this.
Okay.
Those are the things is there. At a high level, I'm just teaching you right now, but those are the things is there. You can do conditional stuff also. Okay, guys, so now demo time. So let me show you. First I have to install the Docker Compose. How can you install it? So Docker Compose, you won't get it by default, we have to install it. So how do we install it? So Docker Compose is another utility. So let me install it. Docker Compose you can install in Windows, Mac and Linux, all platforms, no problem. And here is Linux. I'm going to install in Linux. You can go little slow, but I know that what command I need to run, so I'm just going through. Download is done from this command. Permissions is done with this command. And creating a soft link using this command. And validation from this command. That's Docker Compose installation is done, 1.27. So now this installation is done, wonderful. Now what do you need? You need Docker Compose file, which has a multiple services. So for this demo, I'm going to use one of the my example programs, but on the Google, you will find hundreds of it. So which one I should use it? Docker Compose. I'm thinking which one to use it. I'm looking for some services which where you can have a visualization that is a bit extra, at least two or three services. So this one I think. Okay. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create one file, dc.yaml. And the content I'm going to copy here. Okay, guys, now you see that's coloring, so you can understand which is commented, which is not commented. So see here, now match the discussion. Here I said compose YAML. The file name it can be anything. For time being, I'm just going through that. As a services. So see here, services, name of the services 1, 2, WordPress, DB. So WordPress is one application which is based on the PHP. DB, which is a MySQL, which is a free software. So now each each service has a multiple arguments, what you can see, parameter. So see, image, port, build is not there here, volume, environment, network. Now this parameter depends on, basically is saying before running this, run this. Okay, so depends on, has a multiple capabilities, including running these services first, then run this. And on more capabilities, it also link the environment variable also. So multiple things are there in this. So here you see image, WordPress image, which port it should get open. This is external port, this is the internal port. Volumes, this is a C. Which volume type it is, any idea which volume type this is? Anyone?
Mount.
Mount type, yeah. Mount type. Because it's a not a, it's a using the local host, I mean host machine only. And setting up some of the environment variable. And this is the network. That means this container, whatever you are running with, you'll be having this network, bridge network. Now this network is created somewhere down. Okay. Here. Same goes with here. And so you are total this one. So it's not very difficult to understand. Just copy the content. But by the way, I'll modify this one something. See here it's saying local host. That means if I allow this one, then I will not be able to access from the outside. So what should I do? Because it should be accessible only, proxy will be created, port will be exposed only to the local host. But I right now I'm not in the local host. No, if you're running in the laptop and all, that's okay. But if I'm not in laptop right now, I'm in the VMs actually, accessing from outside. So I'll remove it, or 0.0.0.0, I'll get it out. So removing is a better option. So else you have to give the 0.0.0.0. Which that means from everywhere. So I just did the changes, copy it, and here Docker Compose has been installed. File which is vi docker-compose.yaml. Okay, so I'm writing this one. Okay, done. Saved it. Now, first of all, I'll show you Docker Compose PS. So many commands are there, more or less it's understandable. If you understand Docker, you won't find any problem with the Docker Compose PS. See here, there's no command, state, ports, nothing. Now, up. How do you know all these commands? So, hyphen H you do, all commands you'll get to know. Okay, more or less it's understandable, pretty much self-defined. Up, hyphen D, D means data, I do not lose the console. Now you see, everything will be done by Compose. Just run one command, rest of the things will be done by them. So just imagine if you have a 20 services, how much time you'll save for you. So you know what, every developers, those who develop an application, their job is to also write a Docker Compose so everyone else can use that. Okay, so now everything is done. This is what press is being pulled out. MySQL got done. Container got created, linked. Done. Can I see that now? Yes. See here. So you got the one container of CentOS. Database MySQL, one container of WordPress. Okay. Now, up. Here you see. Now, WordPress container is accessible at 80 port, you see here. So 80 port you can access it. This is the external, this is the internal. Okay, now you want to see the logs of all containers, not one, all. One, see WordPress and see DB. Okay, you want to see the, what else you want to do? You want to stop the services? Stop it. PS. See, exit 0. Can I start now? Yes. Here. Stop and remove also you can do that. I don't want that one. And I want to access the WordPress. So my IP address I forgot actually. My IP address is 80 port. I'm running the WordPress. Okay. This is the WordPress. Done. Okay, so this is the way WordPress, I mean, sorry, Compose will save your life. Compose will save developers' life working with the containers. Right, any questions so far?
If you look at a developer standpoint, right, so after development, right, they need to write the Docker file and upload the image. Then only this particular example will work, right? So
yeah, Docker file. Yes, write a Docker file and same time Docker Compose file also. But Docker Compose file is not always need to only build. See here there is no build. But if you pass the parameter, only image Docker file will come.
Can we include the build process also, like the Docker file and the build, like?
Yeah, you can do that. Got it, guys? Okay. So now I'm updating this.
Rajesh, one question, Rajesh.
Yeah.
So yeah, in case like if I want to run the same container, right? Like okay, I want to run like three containers, like with the same image and everything, right?
Mm-hmm.
So during that case, like do I need to compose Docker compose like the YAML files three times, like to expose it?
No. That's a very good question actually. So there's one command which is called scale command. Okay, let me show you here. Here scale. Where is that scale? Here it is. See. So if you want to change the number of containers for a service, you have to use scale. Let me do that, in fact, rather than talking. Okay, hyphen H. So here, what you can do, the service name. See here, what I want, database I want only one, because I don't want duplicate database, should not be that way. But WordPress container, I want two or three. What I will do, this is a service name, right? So WordPress is equal to three containers I'll get, and see here it got scaled. So two more WordPress container got created. That means right now you have three containers running. Okay. What is the problem? You know, any idea what is the problem?
Host 8 is already exposed.
Right. Yeah. So I could not get it. See here, WordPress. The question was how to run more containers. I run that through that command. But what has happened? The WordPress got exited. Why? Because the port was already allocated, external port. So I should have not done this. What I could do, if I change only 80, I'll keep it only 80, then it will work. Because I was exposing, right? This I will remove it, it will work. So for that you need a load balancer. Okay. So that is the thing. Is that answer your question?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Why we have to remove it actually? So if load balance, like we let's say the image is created, if we don't give the port, right, it won't be exposed to anybody, right? No one can have access.
If you don't give this port, it'll not get exposed to outside. Only it will be running internally 80 port, and then you have one load balancer, Nginx or something like that, and load all the container IP address and the port, and then access through the load balancer.
Yeah, so but container IP address are very dynamic, right? So how to that's a challenge will be there, right?
Huh. So that's a one good question. So here there's a two kind of containers actually. One is stateful and one is stateless. So more or less if you have a stateless name, WordPress is stateless and MySQL is stateful. So for that you have to have a little bit of different for the MySQL you need to have a different strategy. What strategy? Let me talk about a little bit of it also. Think about it. Statefuls will have a data changing all the time. So what you can do, this is a container, okay, of database. So database is divided into two part. One is like engine, okay, MySQL engine, Oracle engine, and there's one data directory. Okay, so what do you have? in the container you have only engine and data directory, you have it at a different location. Okay, this is a data directory. Don't store data directory. I'm talking the production level, this not here. Here it's the same container, but when you implement something like that, so data directory have it the external places which is common across all the containers. So here you have a two engine, two container of MySQL, and they are hitting to the same data directory. So that way, that's one of the tricks. That's one of the tricks you can do. By the way, clustering concept is also there. MySQL cluster or Excel cluster, MSQL cluster, that will also help you. So you have to become an expert in database also.
This is something we can do using volume mount, like, you know, the data directory volume.
Easiest way. Easiest way you can do that, but yes, that's not a production grade of recommendation. You have to create a cluster of Oracle or MySQL or MSQL. It will help you. Now, clustering is something out of this context, but you have to just check it out.
Okay.
Okay, guys. So now I'm updating this note. You have a Docker Compose, all the commands which I run. You're going to check it out. And I'll give you 15 minutes for this lab. And this lab of Docker Compose. And after that, we'll move on to the Kubernetes. Go ahead and let's do that.
If you liked our Docker session so far, please enroll our general membership for $3.99 plan to get access of all the parts.
Along with that, you can access our other tutorials such as Docker, Ansible, Jenkins, Terraform, Splunk, AWS, Azure, and various other DevOps related premium tutorials with our channel membership. If you would have any issues with our channel membership, you can drop an email to us at contact@devopschool.com, or you can also unsubscribe from channel membership anytime if you don't want to continue or did not like the video. To get our channel membership, click onto the join button, select the $3.99 plan, and grow your skills immensely.
Please be kind enough to like it, and you can comment any of your doubts and queries. We will reply to them at the earliest.
Thanks for watching.